I'm going to slip in one trick question.
The others weren't. Okay.
So that question is, how will the rest of the world receive this nuclear posture of view? So much of nuclear doctrine depends on how it's received by the beholder. And
yes.
Do you think that this will be used to send a message? And if so, what message might it send?
Well, I think what the authors of the posture review always hope for, no matter whether they're liberal or conservative, is that it will reassure your allies and raise doubts in your potential adversary's mind about their own plans. Now, will it do that? I think a lot of that depends less on the document than it does on other forms of diplomacy. I mean, if your alliance relations are pretty good, a document like this should work in that fashion. If they're not, it doesn't matter what you say in these documents. People will, your friends won't be reassured, and your enemies won't be made more dubious about their capabilities. I think a lot depends on alliance relations, and I think that's a work in progress. I think the administration's done a very good job in rattling the cages about, don't take us for granted, you need to make more of an effort to do your share. Now, the second part, it's been working on as well. I mean, we've had lots of very high-level people go to South Korea, go to NATO, go to Japan. Depending on how those things work and what they think of the White House efforts, that will probably color how this thing will be received more than anything else. That's my guess.
All right.
Right.
Thanks.
Okay.